What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. And in this video, we are going to go over the update and what new trade I have put on for the smaller account. So with that being said, let's go on ahead, cue that intro, and jump right into it.
I know I'm fine, but the money
okay,
makes
guys. So everything's out here. The account is still up from where we're up over that 15,000 by like $100 and something. So first thing here, you guys know I always have the MES open or the futures open here, gold. So the NUGT trade that I put on in the last video actually did turn out very, very well. It expired useless, so we collected 100% of that profit. So that was an easy, simple little trade. Again, not a trade I'm going to be looking for every week, but it was just something that was pretty cost efficient, cheap, and you know, let me make another 15, 20 bucks. So we're happy there. Another one that we actually did very, very easily today was Oxy. So let's go on ahead over here, OXY. I put on a trade and it was actually to buy it down here at like 61 this week. They have earnings and I believe it is, yeah, tomorrow afternoon, right after the market closes. I didn't want to hold it into earnings. We had this big spike here early today, and really I was already at like 90%, so I bought it back for like 4 cents. You can see this trade here. So yeah, you guys can see I'm literally showing you guys the exact trade confirmation here, so I'm not hiding anything. One to close Oxy, 60 put, bought it back for 5 cents. I believe I sold it for 15 or 16, made my 15 bucks minus commissions, whatever. Now the one thing I didn't do after it is I didn't go buy my shares like I always do. I'll probably grab those first thing tomorrow morning. I'll do it at the open. I haven't quite figured out if I want to go buy another share of PTY or if I want to buy something else. I've been kind of looking at a few other ones, so that's kind of where I'm at with that one. But I do know mentally I got another $15 to spend into stocks. Then you see the other one. Let's update this position first. We're at $53. We were at $55 just as this video opened up. So we are still up on the MES. Good little trade here. I'm not going to put on any MES. I planned on hopefully being able to put on another MES in the, you know, this week sometime. It's not looking like that's going to happen. If we're going to continue to run up, you guys know I only sell MES, which is the S&P 500 future, and it is the micro version rather than the minis. The minis are actually the bigger version. I know how that wording works. And I just haven't had anything that, you know, it's not down. So I'm not selling an option yet on this because I'm never going to get as far out as I got on this one with the market being up. I'm probably only going to get around in here. And I want to get further out, especially with like a 10 delta. So that's the update on that one. My new position, and I mentioned getting into one of these positions in the last video, I believe, or the very first video. And that is CL. Well, that's crude oil. So I'm just going to move this over here, CL, just to show you guys. This is where we are at with it. My screen won't minimize to be able to pull it up. We're flat. I was up like $20 here at the open tonight. Nothing crazy. You guys can see here, this is where I sold it, sold the option, and wow, that thing did not work at all. So we are going to go back to auto, and this thing has to come down pretty far in order for me to get hit on this. So I'm pretty comfortable buying it down here if this actually does happen. That's really why I only took this trade. You can see we have been downtrending. I'm hoping, just like this one right here, we get a pop tomorrow morning, or we get, you know, the next couple of days throughout the rest of the week, we get some green. I'm not looking to take 50% off of this one like I normally do. This one I will probably see, now we're up $10. I'm only looking to make 100 bucks on this trade. Why? It only cost me like 3,000 for, oh, now my buying power is up a little bit higher. That's just because it's at night. So $4,100, let's say, let's round up to $4,200. My buying power, if I make $100 on it within a week or two, it's a pretty good solid little trade here. And then I'll go buy, probably usually when I sell the futures and I get it and I make money off of them, I go and buy something like a stock in Oxy or Coca-Cola, things like that. So those are just the trades that I have now entered. The other trades, again, I am looking at Gold could be another trade if we get another big push down. So again, the ticker that I used for this was NUGT. It was just a simple little trade, went to zero, but nothing I'm literally looking at right now. So go back to the gold future because it is open right now. And that's really the account update, guys. Nothing crazy, nothing fancy. Just this quick little trade here, closing a position here in Oxy due to earnings, and then getting into the CL trade, which is a very, very highly probability trade. Now you guys are gonna see here, it says 33 cents here. Wow, I did not know that's what that did. That's pretty interesting, actually. Let's see if it comes back. No, it literally just took that out. So that's awesome, just learned that during this video. So, but anyways, 33 cents, it actually just needs to go down to, I think I'm going to buy it back at like 22, so I get an extra cent. I clicked 11 cents, and it's actually not even $11. It's actually more than that because every cent is actually $10 on the future for crude oil. So, yeah, very just a quick update, guys. I hope this helps somebody out see what we're doing here. Again, really, really high probability trades. Once the earnings come in on Oxy, I probably will go sell another option in the weeklies for the next week, or even possibly this week if we get a big pull down in Oxy. I don't know if I see that happening, but it is very, very possible. So we just got to see how this works. You guys know I like selling on red days, and not just red days for the overall market. Whenever that asset that I am selling the option on, I want it to be red. I want it to have a little bit of a push down, at least get about a percent drop down within a couple of days at least, and then sell the option. So then I have a better, statistically I'm getting further out and I have better odds and I become profitable much, much faster. And that was really the play here with CL in the crude oil play. So with that being said, thank you guys all for watching, and I will see you guys in the next update.